Thanks for joining us, and today we're going to talk about Secrets of Pranayama Revealed. So pranayama means life force control. Prana is life force and yama means restraint or control in Sanskrit. And so it's a primary technique that people use when they are doing meditation practices. They are using a control of the life force through the breath and they call it pranayama. And so there's many different approaches to doing that. Some people will be just following their breath, in a simple mindfulness breath meditation. Others will be controlling the breath rigorously with multiple inhales and then multiple exhales, or really long inhales and short exhales. So there's a whole variety of different approaches to pranayama in meditation. And so what we want to look at is actually the science of pranayama. How does it work? How does it have an effect on the body? And how does it make us go into a meditative state? So the key aspect of pranayama that makes it actually work is something called heart rate variability or respiratory sinus arrhythmia. And what that basically means is that your heart rate is not always going at the same rate. When you're inhaling, it actually speeds up your heart rate. And when you exhale, it slows down. So there is this respiratory sinus arrhythmia. It is not constant, or what we call heart rate variability. And so when you are doing pranayama in yoga, what you want to do is to accentuate that heart rate variability. So when you're looking at the science of pranayama and you're thinking, how does it work? Actually, to get into heart rate variability resonance so that your heart rate and your breath rate are in resonance with each other and you're able to start going into a meditative state, your breath rate needs to be at 7 breaths per minute or less. So any kind of technique that you're doing, you want to make sure that it brings your breath rate down to that crucial 7 breaths per minute threshold. If you do not, it's very difficult to start shifting into deeper states of meditation. To an internalization and beyond. And so that is the first real step in the science of pranayama, is you need to lower your breath rate to 7 breaths per minute or less. Next important piece about the science of pranayama is that we want to leverage our parasympathetic nervous system. We have a nerve that's part of our central nervous system called the dorsal vagal nerve, or the dorsal vagal complex, and that runs along the anterior part of our spine. And we can stimulate it by doing a elongated or a slower out-breath. And what that does is actually puts pressure on this dorsal vagal nerve, this dorsal vagal complex, which then connects with our medulla oblongata. Now, the medulla oblongata is part of our brainstem, and it is responsible for the autonomic nervous system function of breathing. And so when we are doing this elongated, or really it's a slower out-breath, we are putting pressure on the dorsal vagal nerve, which is then signaling to the medulla oblongata to slow down the heart rate. And then what happens as a result is that our body idle starts to lower, and we start to go into an internalized state, which is the beginnings of meditation. It's called pratyahara in the Patanjali Yoga Sutras. And by doing the heart rate variability resonance breathing, you're breathing at 7 breaths per minute and making that out breath slower, meaning that it goes for a longer period of time. You're actually stimulating the dorsal vagal complex and therefore stimulating your parasympathetic nervous system, and then it affects your medulla and slows down your heart. All of that begins the process of internalization, this pratyahara. So in the science of yoga, you're really looking at trying to get it at the 7 breaths per minute or less, and to elongate, or really to slow down the out breath. All of that will start to shift you into a state of pratyahara, which is internalization, and you will start to feel a response in your body. What is this response, you may ask? It is the galvanic skin response. What you may start to feel is you'll feel like a pulsation, or your hands will feel like they're hot and heavy. You might feel a tingling throughout your body, or tingling in your spine, or a pulsation in your lower lip, or other kind of indicators. These are signs of the galvanic skin response. It is basically your body is shifting away from the sympathetic nervous system into the parasympathetic. And as a result, you are starting to experience these symptoms of going into the freeze response, the galvanic skin response, which is pratyahara in yoga. So in the science of yoga, you are moving from being in a state where you use your pranayama technique, where you are getting into heart rate variability, and then you are starting to shift into this galvanic skin response, into this freeze response, this pratyahara. So that's really where the science of yoga, modern understandings of neurophysiology, and the actual art and science of pranayama interface. We know what's happening in the body, and then we know what's happening in the nervous system, and you will consequently feel these sensations in your body. You know when you start to feel those tinglings that you are actually getting into pratyahara, which is exactly where you want to go, because the science of yoga is about going internal, right? So so that's really sort of the essence behind it. Now, if you're doing any kind of pranayama technique, you just want to know for sure, like at the beginning, is it actually getting you into a state of pratyahara? Are you starting to experience the galvanic skin response? And if you're not, then your technique is not bringing you into pratyahara. And as we know, Patanjali says that is, that step of yoga is essential for getting into these higher states, like dharana, the dhyana, the samadhi. All of those states are predicated on the getting into a pratyahara, into a state of internalization or freeze response. So things to look in your pranayama practice to make sure it's effective, that will lead you into pratyahara, is: are you breathing at 7 breaths per minute or less? The second thing is your out breath longer or slower than your in breath? If it is, you will be stimulating your parasympathetic nervous system, which will slow down your heart rate. It's going to bring you deeper into heart rate variability and into the freeze response, into pratyahara. So if you don't have those things, then you know there's something lacking in your pranayama technique. So those are the principles behind the science of pranayama. These are the principles that we teach at Modern Kriya, and we have many videos on that. There, you check out videos on heart rate variability, resonance breathing, and other practices at modernkriya.com. If you have any questions about the video, anything I've said, feel free to send me an email at info@modernkriya.com. Also check our website at modernkriya.com, and we also have a YouTube channel. So thanks for joining us, and we will see you next time.